Okay, this is the video solution to question number 11 for the fall 2011 exam. And we're told that a website allows us to vote on polls that interest you. So once you find a poll of interest, you click on vote and your response becomes part of the sample. One of the questions was, how many times have you been pulled over by the police? Of the 780 who responded, 70% said 1 to 5 times. You conclude the results tell us little because there's bias. And what's the primary bias here? Well, you've probably identified a couple. Okay, one of them is that you, as the respondent, get to pick which poll you take. So it's not a random sample, right? It's just the people who want to respond to the poll. Okay, and we call that selection bias. Okay, so we have selection bias. And then you might also note, right, that a question about how many times you've been pulled over to the police is probably subject to response bias. Okay. So we have an issue here. We have two biases. Okay, notice the question is asking for the primary bias. Okay, and the primary bias is the one that's going to affect our results the most. Okay, and there are a couple of reasons why the correct answer is selection bias. The first and most important is that the way that this website works is that you only answer the poll, you only actually answer a question if you decide to take it. Okay, so step one is selection bias. So we don't even get to our concern about answering the question until somebody already decides to take the poll. So our primary concern is going to be selection bias. And I think that's probably our primary factor and a good enough justification for why it should be selection bias over response bias.